To get started, what episode are you guys filming right now?
Well, we're now last week. We just finished with Stephen Brogren directing the last four episodes of Now or Never. So it ends with the with a finale that is going to be pretty shocking, I think. I don't want to oversell it too much, but it's the finale. I think we've invented a new term, mid-season finale.
Yeah.
And this week we are shooting what will turn out to probably be a 1 hour special, but it's 2 half hours, but it'll probably be come together as a 1 hour special. And then the first two episodes, and that will ostensibly take place during, maybe the summertime or indeed sometime after graduation. And then the episodes where we really introduce the new grade nines and carry on until the end of the season with some of our, you know, new characters that will be not new now, but will be new when they're introduced then.
So a lot of the cast and crew said that last week filming the graduation was one of the most emotional times ever on the set. And you've obviously been with the show for the entire run. Is that true? Was it really that emotional?
Well, it was certainly one of the most emotional. I have to say the shooting of JT was incredibly emotional. And I recall the last scenes when Lauren and Adamo and Stacey Farber, remember, they'd gone on and we were shooting them after they left DeGrassi. Mm-hmm. But when they knew those were their last scenes, I mean, everybody was in tears there. But there was a lot of tears, partly because of the storytelling itself. I mean, there were just some very emotional scenes anyway. But also when you've got, you know, the Charlottes and the Rays and, you know, people who've been around for so long, mm-hmm. and you look up and you suddenly realize, wait a minute, they're, you know, we'll see them again, but we're not going to see them in the same routine basis as we have. It just added extra poignancy to the scenes. Mm-hmm. And there were six graduating.
Well, some of the characters said that it was their last time filming, but about Ray and them, you said they might still come back. Like, are you following them to university or you're not?
No, we won't be following them to university. If they come back, it will be part of a DeGrassi High School storyline.
Okay.
But there's different ways of coming back. I mean, there's coming back on the air, and then, you know, we'll still be following them, you know, in their Free the Children escapades and adventures. Escapades isn't the right word, nor is adventures. But they're still very much part of our lives. So, you know, they'll be back in the office a lot, mm-hmm. Even if we're not filming them.
Who made, like, the decision and why to not follow? Like, you followed people like Ellie and Paige to university. Did you guys not feel like the storylines in the university were up to par to the high school ones?
Well, I think it's not fair to say that they weren't up to par. But having said that, if you think about it, and we tried for a couple of years, as you know, and our feeling at the end of that was that the stories didn't have the same resonance. And we've tried to come to grips with that ourselves. Partly you can say that truly one of the main characters in the story, in our storytelling, is the DeGrassi school and all the discipline that it requires, bells ringing and people having to do certain things. Mm-hmm. Another way of saying that is when you're in university, you know, if you're carried drunk out of a restaurant and, you know, miss all your classes the next day, who cares? I mean, it's sort of expected of you in university.
Yeah.
Whereas you do that in high school, there are real consequences. I mean, you know, parents will be involved, teachers will be involved, there'll be detentions. So we just found that even though we loved the characters after they graduated and the audience loved the characters, that there wasn't the same drama to the storytelling. And we think when we made that difficult decision, hey, you know, when people graduate, they really are going to graduate, and we'll just bring in a new crop of niners and teners and grow with them. It'll be a shock at first because, you know, it would take a while for people to get used to the new cast. Mm-hmm. But we think that they'll actually enjoy the experience more. And I think that was proven last year.
In the past week, the long-awaited Degrassi app was finally released, and it's been received very positively, high up on all the iTunes charts. What was it like creating the game, and how much of an impact did you have in it?
Well, I was very, very much involved in the following sense. Let me tell you the history of it.
Okay.
We started off, we actually, and you'll know this from the Twitter, we'd actually developed a completely different app last year and got very close to the stage of releasing it. But it was when we got near the end that I looked at it and started to realize, you know what, this is a good app and it will appeal to some Degrassi fans. It was basically a trivia-based app. I said, why are we doing this? I mean, yes, it's fun to put out an app, and apps are cool. But if I really wanted us to sit back, and we did, and brainstorm and say, okay, we've learned a lot. We've learned a lot about the process of creating an app. But what is it we really want to be doing by releasing an app? And what we came up with was, first off, it needs to be something that really allows the viewer to feel a part of the Degrassi world and to feel close to and interacting with the Degrassi world on the one hand. And secondly, it needs to provide an opportunity for people who maybe don't even know what Degrassi is to start to be introduced to the world. Or maybe they know what Degrassi is or think they know what it is, but you know, they've left and they haven't seen it in a while, and you know, get them back into the tent. So we basically took our teachable moment, our learning lesson, and didn't go forward with that app, even though we spent a long time on it and money. And we went back to an idea, and this was something that has been in my head right from the very beginning. Way back in 2001, the website that we created for Degrassi with the help of some very, very bright people, you became a student at Degrassi. And I don't know if you recall that early website, but you had a locker page.
Yes, yes.
You were able to write some blogs on it. You could, you know, have, you know, question and answers. You could send D-mail, Degrassi mail. And the characters were also part of it. So you were going to school with the characters. And if they posted a blog, you could reply to them and they might reply to you, or they'd send you D-mails. And that sense, I always loved that. What we created, in effect, what we created back in 2001 was MySpace. And the only difference between what we created and MySpace was ours was a walled garden. It was all moderated. So it was very important to us because a lot of the viewers back then were younger. We were appealing to a slightly younger audience. And we were very concerned that there'd be moderation. And so really the only difference between what we created and the 800,000 people who followed us and MySpace was that on MySpace there was no moderation. And of course, MySpace was a few years later, and so some of what you could do on MySpace was a little bit more advanced, but not that much more advanced than what we had. I always loved that idea. I mean, after a few years, what we'd done sort of became a little bit passe, and we needed to have things like streaming video and all the things that you expect from a website now. And it was logical at that point to move the website into a partnership with CTV, then CTV, now Much Music, and Team Nick, because they had the back end and could supply the video and podcasts on a very cost-efficient basis. But I love this concept of you becoming a student at Degrassi. And so when we were doing our brain, this is a very long answer to the question. When we were doing our brainstorming on the new app, when someone came in and said, you know, why don't we go back to the, Stephen, you've always been talking about doing a game, something based on becoming a student at Degrassi, making choices. It's almost a Sims kind of game, but based in high school and with the Degrassi characters. Why don't we do it as an app? And I went, all right, this is what we're doing. Got very excited about it, and everybody got excited. So that was the genesis of it.
And speaking of, you mentioned the original, the trivia game. Is there any, would that ever be coming out, or is it completely done? Now that you've released this, are you interested in doing something like that now for the future?
I don't think so. I mean, we've got a whole series of questions that we could make use of at some point and maybe have some contests or, and indeed, maybe even in this app, it's not impossible that we could have a special a special version of it. Actually, you just triggered an idea where maybe we could have the exam episodes, or, you know, the examination episodes. And it would be particularly fun for people who really know the show. But I think we'd have to have a whole bunch of other questions for people who maybe weren't as familiar. Or we just need to make it clear, hey, this particular episode of the app is really for hardcore Degrassians. And, you know, wait for the next month for your app if you're not in that category.
Mm-hmm. And you also said that there's going to be a new episode each month for like 6 months to a year.
Yeah, I think it'll be closer to a year. It's been, you know, quite successful at the launch now. And there's every reason to believe it will just carry on every month until next summer. And, you know, hopefully next summer we'll have another, you know, brand new set of episodes during the summer, you know, the new Boiling Point or the new Now or Never. Mm-hmm. And it would be logical then to carry it on after then, but maybe do a shift or, you know, a revamp of the game so that it's got a lot of the same thrust, but brings in a lot of new features. It would be exciting to have that complete a revamp next year. So my hope would be that it just carries on month after month after month for quite a long while.
When do you plan on rolling out some contests or something for the fans to get the points to type in?
If you check it out now, there'll be an upgrade because we wanted to get it out. And I think it was amazing that we got as many of the bugs addressed before the release as we did. But there's an upgrade coming out as soon as maybe tomorrow or in any event sometime this week, mm-hmm. which will clear up, I hope, you know, any of the remaining bugs. And then you'll notice even now before that upgrade goes up, if you click on the game today, at least now I'm not sure whether this is geo-gated to Canada or not, but you'll see that the very first screen is different. It's actually there's a sponsorship from Pepsi Refresh. And that is the kind of integration. Now, that's only at the very beginning of the game where right now there's a screen saying, or before then there was a screen taking you to extra games from XMG Studios. Mm-hmm. But I can certainly foresee in the upcoming months working with sponsors like Pepsi to do contesting, to do prizing, to, you know, give away future episodes, but also give away physical prizes. And, of course, there's, you know, some big prizes that we can do, like visits to the set or, you know, Skypes with some of your favorite actors, those kind of things. So that's very much on the horizon. But I have to admit that we've been so focused on just getting episode one out and also preparing for episode two, which actually I think you'll find has some very nice differences. I think, you know, I've loved episode one, but I think episode two will have a lot more twists and turns because I think we learned a lot from episode one. Mm-hmm. But after that, I think you'll start to see more in terms of integration, contesting, and that promo code kind of thing.
Okay. Now, the first part of season 11 is called Now or Never. How is this different from the first part of season 10, The Boiling Point?
Well, I think it's similar in concept. It's a little bit longer than The Boiling Point. The Boiling Point was 6 weeks mm-hmm. of four new episodes a week, and this is 7 weeks of four new episodes a week. But I think the concept and the arc is the same in the sense that there'll be all sorts of stories going on. The storytelling is very similar. There'll be the intrigue and the drama. But a lot of stories will slowly lead towards an inevitable conclusion. And when I say inevitable, I'm not sure that people will know what the conclusion is until we have it. But there'll definitely be a sense of closure at the end of Now or Never, in the same way that there was a sense of closure at the end of The Boiling Point, although we knew at the end of The Boiling Point that things were going to change. And so you were left with the question, well, how are they going to change after this? Mm-hmm. And I think you'll be left with a similar question. It's not going to be a huge cliffhanger, but it will be a cliffhanger of sorts. You know, what is going to happen next?
So now that you're starting to film the second half, I'm not sure if you know it yet or you want to say, but do you have a title in mind for the second half of the episodes?
No, basically, we've shot these four episodes that I've described before, sort of the two that will probably be a one-hour special and then the other more starting the new school year with the grade nines.